Okay, hi guys. So, I've been streaming a bit of Mega Man lately, like the original NES games. I did 2, 3, and 4. And so, just for the hell of it, I guess, but might as well continue. Overwatch was turning into a bit of a salt fest anyways, so best to just change gears. And you know, I still really do love Mega Man 5. I see some people regard this as the weakest of the NES Mega Man games. This one in particular, but it had a few problems maybe, but overall I liked it. Visually impressive, I would say. I think the music is really good. I think the biggest problem with it were the weapons, the Robot Master weapons. I believe I've commented before that how even the NES, the Nintendo Power article on this game even said, commented that the Mega Buster is probably the best weapon for just about everything. And that would be why. Alright, now for Wave Man. Hard to predict where his water wave's gonna shoot out from. Because you assume he's going to shoot it from wherever you're standing, but not necessarily.
Hmm.
And of course, that's another thing. Is how often one-up drops are in this game. You might have seen the video I dropped earlier today, my latest venture into Mega Man Rock and Roll. Made a little bit of progress in the Fortress levels, but still a bit left to go, I would say. Those are some tough levels, too. Oh yeah, that was one thing I didn't like about this. And that's the fact that if you get hit while you're charging your Mega Buster, you automatically lose your charge. Come on, Starman, stop up. Man, he is really dicking around this fight. Time for the guy with a really unique stage design, or at least a stage gimmick. I wonder if we'll see this gimmick introduced in Mega Maker. I hope so. It might be a little difficult. The problem might be that it could be difficult for the devs to implement, but it'd be really cool if they could pull it off. I feel like a lot of people really like that. Really like the reverse gravity gimmick, because I have seen it implemented in at least a couple of the fan games, too. Thank you. Useless weapon number one. Which one would that be? Like I said before, a lot of people regard most of the weapons in this game to be pretty useless. God, what was that, like, 3, 4 one-up drops in this level? Yep. Yes. Are you talking about what I commented before about how you lose your charge when you get hit? Or is it just the fact that it's probably the single best weapon in the game? Maybe a combination of both. Yeah, are you used to a lot of people, are you used to people fighting Starman first? I'm used to fighting Waveman first. That's the order I go. But yeah, gravity hold in this game is a far cry from, say, Sigma's Gravitic Flux. Oh crap. It's pretty cool when it flings enemies off screen, but... like so. But the damage it deals is pretty underwhelming for a full screen attack. Yeah, I heard that was a complaint too, that it didn't really introduce anything new to this series. Unless you want to count Beat. Sometimes I can't always get the jump off in time there, but... yeah, like I said, when I commented earlier that a lot of people do regard this one as the weakest of the NES ones. But... Which I can understand why, but I still enjoy it. Oh my god. Not really getting the timing down with his... his attacks there. There we go. This is probably the best weapon in the game. It does say something, though, that Mega Maker, very noticeably buffed all of the, I think all of the Mega Man 5 weapons that are in it. Star Crash is quite useful for this segment, though. Okay, Eddie, this is one point I would have preferred you'd given me weapon energy. Now I don't have... okay, I have enough for one more. Okay. Sweet. Are we referring to Flash Man or Gemini Man? Or both? Hey! Oh yeah, and that's another thing about this one is that awkward rush coil in comparison to other games. This is the only game where rush coil works like that. Yeah, and of course, Mega Man 6 did away with that altogether and introduced those Rush Fusion suits. But then 7 would go back to the OG Rush Coil and would stick with that for the most part ever since. Thank you. Alright, that Crystal Man fight went pretty well. Ah, Napalm Man's your favorite, Robot Master? Seems to rank high on a lot of people's lists, which is why we see him in, he appears in both of the arcade games. As well as... I don't know, just... Although... A couple of cameos, I think. Sadly, never appeared in the Ruby Spears cartoon, except in the intro. Yeah, his stage music's good too. But then again, as I said earlier, I do like a lot of the music in this game. How am I on lives? Well, I'm at 9. I forget if the lives cap at 9 in this game, or if I can go past it. Okay, they do cap. Oh crap. Oh boy. And now I'm... Oh man, now I'm causing them to respawn! Okay, that was some BS, but... Alright, Napalm Man. I have your pattern down pretty well, actually. Which will be... Watch those be famous last words. No, that went pretty well. Thank you. Yeah. Gutsman's karaoke buddy. Along with Concrete Man. I was gonna say, oh right, we have, well, I have to be at full health and weapon energy if I use the M-Tang for it to turn all the enemies on screen into one ops. Otherwise, we can only carry one at a time. Again, it's probably pointless going out of my way for more one-ups at this point. Not helping, Eddie. I think I've probably seen pictures of that Armor X figure. Not sure exactly which one it is, but cause there are a lot of them. Gold variant? Oh, like from X3 then? Okay, yeah. I should check that out too, because again... Oh, neat, it does come with the Z-Sabers. I was gonna say, I should check that out, because I've mentioned before, X3 is my personal favorite Mega Man X game. Anyways, we did get the Power Stone, which I know for a lot of people is really reviled as one of, if not the worst weapon in the series. Even the Top Spin, I think, has been exonerated for the most part, once people figured out how to use it. But everyone hates the Power Stone. I didn't think it was that bad of a weapon. It's a little awkward, yes, but... I don't know, I couldn't find myself completely hating it either. And I did feel there were weapons that were worse. Alright, yeah, time for Thomas the Tank Engine here. And depending on how his AI is feeling, he can be aggravating as all hell to deal with. Oh my god, yeah. Especially when it comes to this brand of BS. Oh, you whore! No, I didn't forget about the E-Tanks, but I've got... I mean, I had maxed out lives, so... I'd rather use one of those than an E-Tank. Okay, will you just die already? Thank you. By the way, one thing I did like about Charge Man's level was the effect of the, kind of like the train shaking as it goes. Something like Mega Maker and other a lot of other games like it didn't really... I don't think they did so much, but I don't know. It was a cool effect. Anyways, we're on to Proto Man, quote unquote, fortress. Oh yeah. Yeah, Tiger City for this first segment. This bastard here. And now I think, yeah, I gotta... If I don't kill him at the right spot, he's just gonna keep respawning there. Okay, now time for everybody's favorite. Unless... I just figure a way to cheese my way around it. Like so. Hey, Dark Man Mark 1. All right, just got a nota. In this one, you can't use the water wave unless you're standing on the... unless you're on the ground. You can't do it in midair. Thank you. shit, I'm... Oh no. Ooh, okay. Ah, thank you for that. Yep, more tigers. Okay. Darkman Mark II. Yeah, gyro attack seems to be the easiest way to take out the Apache Joes. Since it kills them in just two hits. Okay, time for the snake blocks. Rip right from Super Mario World. Which I believe... I think both these games came out the same year, too. or within a pretty close space of each other. So yeah, surely one was a bit inspired by the other. Oh shit, this... Oh, this isn't good. Okay. Damn, that Power Muscler fucked me up. Oh god, there's another one. Actually... See, that's why the Power Stone is useful. Oh, shit. Okay. Darkman Mark III. You can just go ahead and... Yeah. I'll take the death to just... Not gonna waste the E-Tank on that. Hello, off-key Proto Man. Yep, of course. You're a sham. And that takes care of the last Dark Man. Oh gee, who saw this coming? Right, if you recall, Dr. Light is kidnapped by, who he thought was Proto-Man at the very beginning. For what reasons, I'm not quite sure, except maybe in order to, make Proto-Man look bad. Rush, please. Oh, really? Was there a grammar mistake there? Now for this bit from Dustman's level. Even though our charge shots only destroy one of these blocks each now. And drop the one up in the spike pit like a troll. I don't think it matters too much though, because yeah. Okay. Dick. Oh, geez, you're... Alrighty. Yeah, Big Pets is the official name of that boss. Rather strange name for it, but... Ooh, actually... Might as well use this here, because the other side of that should also have an M-Tank. Yeah. Yeah, those are the parts I find the Power Stone quite useful for. Yep, Circling Q9. Is this boss? But it's pretty easy. Thank you. Not that I anticipate I'm gonna need this many E-tanks and the M-tank, but hey, we got it at least. Okay, boss rush. Gravity Man again. Yeah, that was something I always thought weird about the boss rush in this game, is that it puts you back in the original boss rooms rather than like a fortress atmosphered boss room, which honestly felt a little lazy to me. Charge, man. This could be another reason why everybody hates the Power Stone. Because it's Charge Man's weakness, and even with it, he can be a little annoying. Wave Man. Gyro Man. Napalm Man. Stone Man. Star Man. And last but not least, Crystal Man. Alright, now for the Wily Press. He is weak to Star Crash, but can be a little hard to hit him with it. Like so. Otherwise, just, charge Mega Buster. Yep. Okay, final level. There are a couple of these... couple of those walkers at us. Alright, final boss time. First, Wily Machine number 5. Now for the real deal. Really, the easy way to do this is with B, because he really doesn't have any other Robot Master weaknesses. B's the most reliable way to deal with them. Alright, and that's it. Maybe he still has the super arm from Mega Man 1 after all. Number 33, Gravity Man. Yukiko Mori. Number 34, Wave Man. Hideyuki Mono. Number 35, Stone Man. Kento Nishi. Number 36, Gyro Man. Katsunari Oguri. Number 37, Star Man. Tatsumi Segusa. Number 38, Charge Man. Toshiaki Sugiura. Number 39, Napalm Man. Shinichiro Seki. And number 40, Crystal Man. Yusuke Murata. Who was also the same person who designed Dust Man for Mega Man 4. Which is pretty cool. Alright, that's Mega Man 5, then. For... Another fun run on this one for me. Again, yeah. Again, as you say, a lot of people kind of sleep on this one a little, but I still very much enjoy it. Yeah, as far as the original series is concerned, I don't think... As far as official entries in the original series, I can't think of any that are genuinely bad. Alright then, guys. I don't know. Tempted as I am to keep on going tonight and do Mega Man 6, I think I'll call it a night here. It's been a good night. So I think I'll do that. So thank you all for watching, and yeah, again. Have a good night, everybody.